By 1990, one in five of the population will be retired. In a city the size of Norwich, that means 28,000 people. Most people hardly spare a thought for their retirement, little realizing how devastating can be the loss of occupation and workmates. A varied program of leisure activities can do a lot to keep people in touch with their community, make new friends, and remain active long into their retirement. City of Norwich Amenities Department and the Eastern Council for Sport and Recreation have taken the initiative in setting up such a program, utilizing facilities that are used less during the daytime, such as the city's three main recreation centers. Costs are kept to a minimum and, in addition, resources owned by industry and commerce are used for little or no charge. Since the activities happen during off-peak hours, pensioners can use their bus passes to travel to and fro. Wherever possible, the council tries to use the skills and talents of the retired people themselves to pass on to each other the knowledge and expertise they've gained over the years. Olive and Wally Skiggs, both qualified badminton coaches, run a thriving club in their retirement.
I've had a hip operation and I still play. Although I can't run, I can still manage to get the shuttle when it comes to me. Nine times out of ten it comes to me rather than hitting it over my head so it doesn't come to me.
I think it's made life for some of them. They've come out and they've formed friends. I think for one or two it was quite an effort to come out originally, but they have formed quite some friendships. They go out for picnics, they go out for evening meals sometimes, some of them together. And I think it's made a lot of difference for them. It's been a great life for them.
But having said that, we do in fact include people who are borderline. So if you're living a little bit further away than that, then...
Activities promoter Moira Forbes has been employed to act as a catalyst for the scheme.
Those of you who've managed to have a look at the programme, you'll see that there's quite a lot going on. There's about 40 different things now. And it has been successful, I think, mostly due to people like yourselves, who've given me a tremendous amount of help. We are going to split up into groups. This afternoon we've got Keep Fit, Indoor Pitch and Putt. Try to just move your arms as opposed to moving yourself, all right? Just your arms that move behind.
All sorts of ways of presenting the scheme are used, such as come and try it events, courses and competitions. At a come and try it event, you can have a go at three or four different activities on the same day. This proves a very effective way of introducing the scheme to a group on a pre-retirement course.
Fingers must be placed on the ball in this manner. The centre finger must be on the centre of the running surface. And the far side must be on your left. If you're bowling on the back hand, the far side must be on your right.
Courses attract many newcomers, often helping people to gain the basic skills and confidence they feel are necessary to join a club or start one of their own. Many friendships were made on the intermediate bowls course, and several new clubs have been formed as a result.
Back bowl and out bowl. That's all you do. Take your time. Just relax. Back bowl, out bowl. That's our idea.
Summer coming along.
What will you be doing then?
Bowling.
Bowl.
And up here, of course.
And up here. Yeah. So you'll try and keep the two things going, will you?
Pitch and putt.
Pitch and putt as well?
I hope so, yeah.
Yeah. So it's opened up a lot of new things for you, has it?
Oh, yeah, definitely, yeah.
And what about your wife? What's she going to be doing? Is she still working?
Yes, she's still working.
Still working.
We were hoping it was going to be this year, but it's next year now when she retires.
So, but you're in an unusual situation there, Russell,
yes.
With yourself working and your wife's working and you're retired. Not quite.
Not too good.
Unlucky.
Most clubs meet throughout the year. The Pitch and Putt Club organises indoor practice sessions during the winter months, moving outdoors in the summer. In addition, they offer a wide range of other activities all year round, including regular whist drives, outings and evening socials. The activities promoter encourages clubs to become self-organising whenever possible, thus leaving her more time to set up new projects. Active pursuits are complemented by less energetic ones, such as the art classes, singing groups, talks, and the wine circle, formed as a result of a winemaking course. Often the activity is just a grand excuse for a good social get-together.
If you're both drivers, make sure one of you drinks.
This seems something that both of us could enjoy doing, drinking, and the friends we've met here, really. That's an added bonus.
And such a wide circle of friends you make. It's really incredible. It just grows from one small beginning. Mm. The first step, once you make the first step, you're away then. I've only been up here in Norwich for 4 years, and frankly, I'm amazed at what goes on. You know, it's, you know, the first little nibble was the wine class, Mr. Marks, and from there, I've spread out into, as I say, our kitchen part, bowls, and there's not enough time now. There's just not enough time. It's fantastic.
Strings from Edmonton forward on strings, silver string.
Oh, I know what you mean, yeah.
It's that.
Yeah. With the pins.
Yeah, it's that. Yeah. Or this painting the tongues.
I think initially they come for the activity. You know, if it's art, they want to learn to paint. But having got there, the social role perhaps becomes greater even than the activity. There's an element of both, I think, involved with everything.
Yeah.
The wine circle are beginning to meet in each other's homes now for drinks and sessions, I don't know what you'd call them actually, friendly, I suppose, social gatherings. Yes, there's a lot of that. There's trips organised to Yarmouth and to other places of interest. That's been a nice spin-off, actually, and something you can't always keep tabs on because the groups do that themselves. We recently formed what we've called a Federation of Retired Activity Groups. Sounds rather a grand title, but it's a way of getting all the groups to come together under one sort of heading. And we're starting off rather simply by organising 3 social events and then a big Christmas party, which we'll have in one of the big halls in Norwich.
Your fingertips touching.
Up I come,
and I support round about the hip.
Make sure the neck is nice and long,
and let the half shoulder stand.
And then you can come slowly out.
And again, relax the back.
Elderly people tend to be hesitant about joining clubs and groups, therefore, as expected, the initial response to the scheme was slow. The first event attracted 30 participants who enjoyed an afternoon of bowls, petanque, table tennis and croquet. Soon afterwards, archery and badminton were added to the list of activities available. Since then, the scheme has grown by leaps and bounds, now catering for upwards of 400 people a week and includes such varied activities as photography, cookery, a health and beauty course and the Elderberries Gardening Club. Surprisingly, many of the strenuous pursuits have been the most popular, even for people new to them. Bill and Joe Knight moved to Norwich when they retired 18 months ago.
I think I can probably manage rather more than I could 20 years ago.
I was writing to a friend the other day and said that I thought I felt 10 years younger. These are sort of things I'd have never thought of doing. Settle down to well, you know, just go and meet someone and have coffee and that's it. See? These aren't things I'd ever dreamt of doing.
A scheme like this is really worthwhile and is marvellous. I think it's essential for other parts of the country to adopt schemes like this, because this is the most valuable scheme, an extremely valuable scheme that makes an awful lot of difference to life. We could be, with us in particular, in a strange town where we know virtually nobody, we could be almost on the desert island.
Wait a minute, that one's still there. Still there. Still there.
The Patent Club have organised an informal afternoon for interested beginners to have a go at the game and meet some of the regular club members.
That's number two.
That's yours.
So there's only one then.
One.
Just the one.
The Open About Club that we now belong to, that means to say that there's at least about 50 people have an opportunity every Wednesday of meeting together and either having talks or visiting various places, so that you meet so many other people, you see. So I think it's, I think that Norwich has done very well indeed.
If a scheme such as this is to continue to grow and flourish, it's essential to make contact with people before they retire and settle into a routine. This is best done through some sort of pre-retirement course, yet only 6% of the working population in this country receive any formal preparation for retirement. The responsibility of industry and commerce towards their employees in this respect can't be overstressed. Moreover, it's well within the means of many local authorities to implement similar programs. It's simply a question of matching existing resources with the demands of the retired, and can be achieved at surprisingly low cost.
The thing that absolutely, one of the things that absolutely amazes me, that despite the excellence of the facilities that are offered, more people don't participate in what's available.
I do have this feeling that it's very unwise to retire and not put anything in its place, in the place of work. I think you can become very old and, you know, miserable, really, if you stay at home and don't do anything. Depends on the sort of person you are. I think if you're the sort of person that needs other people, then it's vital to get out and join this sort of organisation.
Well, I feel absolutely certain if they would take the plunge and get out and join one of these activities, then it doesn't matter whether they go along to one and find that isn't the one that they really want to join. That doesn't matter a great deal. There could be plenty of activities going on in Norwich, as you well know. Go along to another one until they find one that is suitable to their needs. And I'm sure that if they did that, this fear of meeting people would disappear. They would thoroughly enjoy themselves and wonder why on earth they started to be miserable all day.
I was overjoyed when I found that there was this scheme, and I thought no more fears about organising my time or, you know, being happy. I thought, here it is already made on my doorstep. It's been a real godsend to me.